Today, we discuss painting in 7 Days to Die. Now, we've got a lot of info to cover and no time to waste, so let's get to it. Painting is one of the funner aspects of 7 Days to Die. While it does not give you any offensive or defensive benefits, it is pretty cool to be able to paint up your base to look like whatever you want. Just because we're living in the zombie apocalypse doesn't mean we can't have nice things. So today I'm going to break down the basics of painting, and we're going to start off with the equipment that you're going to need, namely a paintbrush and some paint. The first item you're going to need is a paintbrush. This is an extremely common item that can be looted practically everywhere. Soon enough, you will have paintbrushes coming out your ears. But just in case you cannot find a paintbrush, they can also be crafted in your inventory. All you need is 2 wood and 1 leather. And really, all you need is 1. The paintbrushes will never degrade. You can use the same one over and over and over again. So once you have 1 paintbrush, you have all the paintbrushes you will ever need in 7 Days to Die. The next item you're going to need is paint. And there are a couple of ways that you can get paint. First, you can get paint by scrapping down dye. Every dye that you scrap down gives you 15 paint. So if we go ahead and scrap down this red dye here, you'll notice that in 2, 1, boom, 15 paint from that one die. So every die that you scrap down will give you 15 paint. So by scrapping down those 8 pieces of die, we got ourselves 120 paint. The next way to get yourself some paint is by mixing it up at the chemistry station. All you need is 1 chrysanthemum and 1 oil, and you can mix up yourself a whole bunch of paint. 1 chrysanthemum and 1 oil will give you 100 paint, and it only takes 6 seconds to craft. So 1 oil, 1 chrysanthemum, 100 more paint. And now that we have our paintbrush and our paint, let's get out there and demonstrate how to use these items. Painting in 7 Days is really, really simple. All you have to do is equip your paintbrush like I have right here, and then we can go ahead and access the paint menu. So on the keyboard, you're gonna press the R button, and that will bring up your materials list. There are a total of 177 different paint options. And all you have to do is select whichever one you want. So let's go ahead and select this cabinet red side. There we go. Now you'll notice down on my icon on the paintbrush on my tool belt, it has changed color. So it shows you on the tool belt which paint you are actually going to be using. So we'll go ahead and exit out of this screen and we will get to painting. All you have to do is walk up to the surface that you want to paint and activate. Boom, there it is. If you right click on your mouse, that will paint a block. And if you left click on the mouse, that will remove the paint. So right click paint, left click remove paint. For those controller users out there, it's going to be the left trigger to paint and right trigger to remove the paint. You'll also notice down in the bottom right hand corner, it shows you how much paint you have left. So currently I have 1,216 paint in my inventory. That way, as you're painting your blocks, you will always have an idea of how much paint you have left. Now let's go ahead and hold that R button to bring up the radial menu. Now you'll notice that we have a few options. We have the materials section that will open up the different painting options we have available. We have the paintbrush, which only paints a single block. And then we also have the paint roller. Let's go ahead and check out the paint roller. So we'll select that option. And now when we paint a section, you'll notice that it paints a 3x3 block area. And if you hit remove, you will also remove that 3x3 block area. So the paint roller is a great way to paint large areas at the same time. Now let's take a look at the final option in the radial menu. So if we open that back up, you'll notice that we can do what is called a texture picker. So as you can see, I'm staring at a cabinet door here that I've just painted. And let's say I want to continue using that paint. Well, if we use the texture picker, we can actually select that paint, and if you notice on the tool belt on the bottom here, my paint has actually changed to this texture right here. So we pretty much just picked this texture, and now we can go ahead and continue using that texture. That feature will save you a lot of time from going back and having to search through the many pages of paints that you have available. Now let's take a look at the materials screen. As you'll notice, we have 177 total paint options available. There are a total of 3 whole pages of paint to choose from. Now, one thing I did feel it important to point out is that every paint option has a paint cost. So if you see right here, it says paint cost 1 per meter. That is not uniform. It is not 1 per meter for every texture type. In fact, there are a total of 18 texture types that cost more than 1 per meter. For instance, on page 2, all of the metal paint options cost 3 per meter. So all of these here, all of these here, and then all of these up to the metal wrought iron. So everything between the beige metal roof and the metal wrought iron actually cost 3 per meter, as does the tar paper texture. So what does that mean, costing 3 per meter? Well, as you see, we have 1,197 paint available in our inventory. So if we go ahead and exit out of that and paint a single block, you'll notice our paint went down to 1,194, but we only painted one single block. That's because every block that we paint with this texture will cost us 3 paint instead of 1. So keep that in mind when calculating how much paint you're going to need in order to paint your structure. Now let's take a look at the dev paintbrush. Now, as you can see, I have a regular paintbrush equipped in my hand, and if we open up the radial menu, you'll see that our options are rather limited. However, if we switch over to the dev paintbrush, which is a little pinkish purple color, easy to identify. Now, when we open up the radial menu, you'll notice we have a whole bunch of new options. For instance, we have the paint all sides option. This allows us to paint every single side of a block without having to paint them individually. We have the spray gun, which paints a huge area with whatever paint you have selected. You want to be very, very careful with this option because it really does spray a lot of paint over a very wide area. And we also have the copy block option. So let's say we didn't want to paint every single block in a build that we were making. Instead, what we can do is copy that block, boom, and you'll notice on my tool belt, it dropped a whole bunch of blocks that were painted up just like the one we copied. So when we put those down, you'll see that they were already pre-painted. Again, we could paint all the sides. So let's paint all the sides of this block here. There we go. And then once again, let's use that copy block option. And once again, we have copied that block. It's been entirely painted. So now when we put those blocks down, they are completely painted. Here, let me go put one out here so you can actually see it. So we've copied that block and it has been painted 100% all the way around, without us actually having to manually paint the block. Now, this can only be done with the dev paintbrush, or with a regular paintbrush, it can be done if creative mode is on. Painting in 7 Days to Die can be a whole lot of fun. You can turn your base pretty much into anything you want. With 177 different paint textures to pick from, you can get very creative with your base designs. Now, if you'd like to see some more awesome tutorials for 7 Days to Die, I've created a very special playlist that you can access by clicking the box in the top right corner of the screen. But for now, this is Savin saying thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me in Savin's World. And remember, the average gamer is always king of the hill on the bell curve.